Bismillah. Question says, can we say that depression is a sign of weak iman? Sometimes we can't say that clearly, and other times we can't say that clearly. Why do you have depression, and what are you depressed about? Why are you depressed? Based off of what? You're depressed because of material things? Because of worldly gain and loss? Then there lies no doubt. You have sorrow about something that you shouldn't have sorrow about in the first place. You shouldn't be busying yourself with these things. You shouldn't be chasing after them, running after them. That's not your place as a believer. That's first and foremost and brief. And secondly, there could be something that could take place that's a religious issue. Something that's painful, that's hurtful, with regards to iman and the mu'mineen, that causes you to be depressed. Thirdly, last but not least, is the general emotion of depression. That's not necessarily a sin. The emotion of anger isn't necessarily a sin. The emotion of lust, of greed, is not necessarily a sin. But the sin comes in that emotion or that thought becoming an idea and a plan, let alone into an actual action. As Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu ta'ala narrated in the Sahih, he told us about the eyes, about the hands, he told us about the feet, all of these things. He says, وَالْعَيْنَانِ تَزْنِيَانِ. The eyes make zina, the hands, the feet, etc. He says, وَالْقَلْبُ يَتَمَنَّى. And the heart wishes, the heart hopes. وَالْفَرْجُ يُصَدِّقُ ذَلِكَ أَوْ يُكَذِّبُهُ. He says, and the last final step is the sexual organ. The final translation of thoughts, of emotions to deeds is the actual zina. So if you see something or hear something or have a feeling, that's not necessarily a sin. Being depressed initially isn't necessarily a sin, but what the depression leads to. You didn't seek help in Allah. You didn't say the necessary adhkar. You left off the salah. You began to drink. You began to smoke. You shaved your beard. You took off your hijab. You stopped falling to things that Allah clearly told you to avoid. Now that's a clear what? That's a clear sin. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu narrated that the Prophet ﷺ, he used to seek Allah's refuge from the following things. Allahumma inni a'udhubika min al-hammi wal-hazan. He says, O Allah, I seek your refuge, I seek your protection from grief, things about the past. And he says, min al-hammi wal-haf, future and past. We know that the Prophet ﷺ had the strongest connection with Allah. He was the best of Allah's slaves, yet still he asked Allah to protect him from these things. إِنَّمَا أَشْكُوا بَثِي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. He said, I complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and my huzn, my sadness, my grief about Yusuf alayhi salam. What happened to my son? What you did, what you said, how you conspired against him. Everybody understand this? He says, وَعَلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. He says, and I know about Allah that which you don't know. So to just be depressed in the beginning is not a bad thing. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave advice. He said, لَا تَغْضَبْ. Don't become angry. The ulama, they interpret this hadith to mean the following things. Number one is actually don't get angry. And the second interpretation is don't act upon your anger. Don't execute your anger. Don't translate the emotion of anger into a deed. Because anger is natural. You can't necessarily control that. But if you get mad, don't strike, don't smack, don't curse, don't slander, don't break. Everybody understand this? So we have the concept of implementing the depression, falling weak to the depression. We have the concept of not fighting off the depression and why you're getting depressed and why you're depressed. I'm depressed because the Muslims are getting killed and we're not doing anything about it. That's a good thing. I'm depressed because I lost money or this sister or this brother or so on and so forth. So it has to be detailed. It has to be what? It could be a sign of low iman, and depression could also be a sign of high iman. It could be a sign of what? Strong iman, depending on the thing and what you do. Hopefully that's clear and hopefully that makes sense. Inshallah.